Well, hello everyone, and welcome back to my channel. So, today I am here to offer you guys a quick little update on my N-scale train layout, as I believe a couple of you would enjoy seeing the small little changes that I've made around here, which is what I'll be getting into very momentarily. But first new thing I want to show off, for those of you who may remember my last layout update back in October, when I had the new Rapido -840CMs and a Canadian National running around on my track, and that a couple of you in that video said you really wanted to see the BC rails running around next. Well, that's what I more or less, I kind of stuck with that promise to a couple of you. Although, unfortunately, I got two of the BC rail barn -8s from Rapido, but unfortunately, I only have one actual locomotive in service at the moment. The other one here is temporarily out of service with a small little issue with the truck, which is more or less my fault to be honest with you. Basically, what happened was after I was done doing a bit of scenery work, just simply forgot to do the quick little vacuum on the track, so a ever so small little bit of turf ended up getting jammed in the front truck, I believe. So spoke with people at my hobby shop, and I think they strongly recommended I just take it to Rapido to get that fixed. Which really, they're only like 45 minutes away from me, so they're not that far, so definitely not the worst that could have happened, but kind of sucks. But I'm sure that happens to a lot of people in this hobby, that silly little mistake where we forget to do the vacuum and then turf gets kind of jammed in the trucks or even ballast. I'm sure that happens a lot, but anyhow, now to time to get on to the actual couple small new changes I've done around here. The first thing I want to point off, as I briefly mentioned about doing a bit of upgrades on the scenery. Well, yes, in the bare lofts I had, like here, here, and everywhere else, I just got tired after a while of just seeing the same old flat green grass in the bare empty lot, so decided to change it up in a couple areas, make it look a little different, and just see how it looked. So that's one thing I was working on over the last couple months, and so far I'd say it's came out pretty decent. Like in this empty lot here, I just added a lot of foliage to make it look like we got some bushes and gullies here. Thought that would look, that looked rather nice. Then a couple other areas, I got some deeper grass on technically what would still be a city property, because on the actual business's property, yes, of course, they'd want to maintain their grass, so I made it flat there, but on what's technically still city property, made the grass look a little bit deeper, so thought that looked rather nice. Same as over here, like with my camping trailer scene, of course, what made the grass look nice and flat on their property, but what's technically still city property, just did a bit of work on the grass, made it look rougher, and I think that came out really nice. So, there was one thing I was working on over the last couple months, just basically trying to upgrade the scenery and make it look different in some areas. So now to get onto the actual couple new scenes that I've added, here's the first one I have to show off. This is a new Pizza Hut restaurant, and this was actually a cardstock kit I purchased off of eBay. Just thought it was worth a try, so built it up, put it in place, and so far I think the scene looks pretty nice. Have yet to get any cars for the parking lot. Just got one lone dude standing outside the restaurant, but so far I think the scene looks pretty nice. Really hope to also get a pizza dude walking outside on the gravel if I could find one. So that would look like look nice also, but there was one new scene that I did. And also in this empty lot where I previously just had a big Canadian flag right here, I kind of decided to add a little property scene, try that out. So got a house with some property out in the fields, and I thought this look came out pretty nice. Got even some dude working on the grass, their dog. I thought that scene looked rather nice as well, and once again made the grass look much rougher on city property, what's still city property, so thought that came out really nice. There was that new scene. And finally, the last actual new scene that I did for the train layout, I purchased one more cardstock kit off of eBay, and in this empty lot where I previously had the foundation of some old abandoned spur track leading into what was once the site of an old abandoned factory, but in my last update back in October, I explained how I got tired of that scene and decided to try a new construction scene. Well, across from the construction scene, I recently purchased this fine little fish and chips restaurant kit, and I installed it for this small little corner here. Fish and chips, a fast food restaurant, and I think it came out pretty nice. Definitely thought it was worth a try, so I think it came out pretty decent, the new fish and chips, right next to the interchange spur line. And then even over here, this is something also that's a little new. I got some railway maintenance crews testing out the main line signals, as you always see that in real life, in the designated Canadian National Company car. Thought that would look pretty decent as well, so. Yep, I believe now I just about explained everything there actually is to see in terms of the couple new scenes that I've done. Although I've added a couple more extra details also, like for my baseball diamond scene, I recently got some figures since October. I installed some people, I got some players on the field now playing ball. Like we got the pitcher, the batter, the catcher, some dude on third getting ready to score, then a couple other infielders. Thought that would look pretty nice for the baseball scene. And also for my small little river scene, I got a couple new canoers, which I've added to the realistic water. Thought that would look pretty nice, the canoers. Same thing as on the over here. Got one more set of canoers. And then finally some people fishing off the road bridge. Got some people fishing, which I thought would look pretty decent. And one more couple just sitting down on a bush right by the water fishing. One more couple down there. Thought that looked pretty nice also. So in terms of kind of adding just more details over time, that's the last thing I had to show off in terms of what was new actually on the layout. Looking towards the other half, everything down here is still basically the same as you last seen it. Everything is basically still the same down there. Except for a couple more animals I got in this corner, a couple barn animals from Woodland Scenics. Thought that looked pretty nice, the barn animals, but anyhow, I believe I now just about showed everything there is to see for what's new on my train layout, the couple small changes that I've made. And very soon I should look to do a full-on layout tour, as I usually do that sometime early in the year, my annual layout tour, so look forward to that. It definitely won't be long, so yeah. So with that, thank you all for watching. Any questions, please don't hesitate to ask, and I'll talk to you guys next time. So, thank you for watching, and stay safe. Peace.